Marriage is like a garden. Like, you gotta water it and give it sunlight. And Morticia and Gomez are always looking for the good things about each other to praise, to build up. They have a deep shared meaning of their family. And their family is literally everything.
I think we've all learned something from these horrible goth weirdo monster people.
Oh my gosh, it's so messed up. Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies. This is
Alan Seawright, guy who needs to adjust his shirt, professional filmmaker.
pat your stomach.
And I need therapy and to go to the gym.
I think he looks hella fine. Now here's the thing, folks. Today, in honor of Halloween, I love healthy marriage movies, and there aren't that many healthy marriage movies.
Well, it's tough to get drama out of a healthy marriage because it's like people getting on.
But what you can get is comedy.
You can get good comedy out of it.
Especially if the healthy marriage is super kinky.
Super kinky and sort of murdery.
Leather straps, red hot pokers.
Later, my dearest.
They have shared interests.
They do have shared interests.
So we're going to talk about, what did you call them? Morton Goats?
Morton Goats. Morticia and Gomez from the Addams Family movies.
We're not.
Listen, it's been a long couple of months.
Morton Goats is not a thing. Now, like, hashtag Morton Goats is going to start, like, blowing up
it's
now.
It's not.
It's not going to happen.
Please don't.
We're looking at the 1990s Barry Sonnenfeld versions. Mm-hmm. Largely because the animated ones aren't as kinky, and we demand some serious kink in our healthy, happy marriages.
To passion.
To paradise.
To pain.
Tonight.
And we're going to use this as a launching pad. There's a book by Dr. John Gottman called Seven Principles for Making Marriage Work. So we're going to talk about what the principles are as illustrated by Morticia and Gomez. But I think we should just go ahead and dive in.
Great, let's do it.
She's asleep.
Look at her. I would die for her. I would kill for her. Either way, what bliss.
Oh, man. Okay. I just... Every...
Unhappy, darling.
Oh, yes.
Every single shot of Angelica Houston, she's in like a 40s noir movie. Some of them are with Raul Julia. But every single shot of Morticia.
Gomez. Son, il me perce comme un poignard.
No, Tish. That's French.
Oui.
Cara mia.
En garde, Monsieur Soleil.
Gomez. Last night, you were unhinged. You were like some desperate, howling demon. You frightened me. Do it again.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so right out of the gate, I want to talk about, with you, my filmmaker friend.
Yeah.
How the
what
Addams...
the hell is going on?
Well, because you had in the 60s, you had the original TV series sure. where they're creepy and they're kooky and they're in love and everything. But this got a major 90s update.
Also, it got a major Barry Sonnenfeld update because Barry Sonnenfeld is Tim Burton without all the bullcrap.
Barry Sonnenfeld, you have our permission to put that on your business cards. Tim Burton without all the bullcrap.
No,
because this is pre-Men in Black. This is
this is pretty early in his career. I think he'd done a couple of films at this point.
Yeah.
And he was actually at Cal Arts with Tim Burton and Brad Bird and a whole bunch of the Pixar crew. They were all there at the same time. Super stylized. It's a live action cartoon. The script is just a sitcom script.
I'll be the victim
all your life.
It's not a big movie script. It's mostly just weird one-liners. Do it again.
And you get...
it's just great.
The first thing I want to talk about is called shared love maps.
Oh, right? Okay.
And a love map is in your brain, like, your understanding of who your partner is. What their likes are, what their dislikes are, what their passions are.
Okay.
What they want out of life. Right here in this first scene, he knows she doesn't like the light. This is the first time I noticed that there's some weird Burton-esque
little plant thing that's like,
it's like,
and it's
light.
Like hiding from the light.
I totally didn't notice that before.
Dude, this movie is packed to the brim with weird crap in the background like that. That's just like so strange and so specific, and there's tons of detail.
Right out of the gate, he's closing the blinds for her. Of course, he's using a sword. He's on guarding the blinds. But he's immediately seeing to her comfort, right? And to what it is that when she says the light, he automatically knows she does not want the light.
Right.
And he is very, very attentive to her feedback and to her needs, to her likes and her dislikes.
Extremely attentive.
And there's this undercurrent throughout the series that they have a very robust,
extremely robust sex life.
Yes.
Robust is the correct word.
But she speaks French to him. He speaks, Spanish to her. And I just have a hard time, they've recast and they're going to remake the Addams Family and they've done it with cartoon. They're going to do it live action again. And I just think we got perfection.
Yeah, you're not going to top this.
Do you think she minded?
Of course not. She adores you.
I'm making such a mess of things. Gomez, how do you do it? How can I be like you? How can I be suave?
Ooh, Christopher Lloyd is the greatest cartoon character.
The most sublime creature on earth. Yes, that's it.
We're back. Nose is powdered.
Oh, she blinks.
Perfection achieved. We are the luckiest brothers on earth. We are unworthy of such splendor, undeserving of such radiance.
Oh, that's right. We should have ugly girls.
So number two is nurture your fondness and admiration.
Okay.
And so here we see Gomez, he's telling Fester, woo her, admire her, make her feel like she's the most sublime creature on the planet.
Sure.
And of course,
Fester's great at this.
Fester just completely botches it. But this comes from, it starts with a friendship, but Gomez is completely invested in, it's like we never stop dating.
Oh yeah. He's doing the Cyrano de Bergerac playbook too, of like way flowery, overblown, just insane compliments and stuff. And it never even slowed down.
You were so beautiful, pale and mysterious. No one even looked at the corpse.
Well, and the important thing is, like, Morticia totally digs that.
Yeah.
Because if she didn't...
Then it would be bad.
Then it would be bad, and that would be a poorly construed love map.
If I did that with my wife...
She'd be like, please stop.
It would last about 20 minutes.
In some relationships, it would come across as insincere because people have different love languages.
Sure.
What I see about their relationship that I think is really beautiful is this focus on and acknowledging the positives. Mm-hmm. So one of my favorite stories is two people walking on the same sidewalk, same time of day. One of them says, it's a bright, beautiful day. The birds are singing. It's wonderful. And the other person says, the sun's too bright. It's too hot. And I wish those birds would shut up.
Yeah.
Yeah. In large part, in life and in marriage, you get what you are looking for. And a lot of times, like, little annoyances build up over time. And one thing that's beautiful about Morticia and Gomez is they are always looking for the good things about each other to praise, to build up. Like, this is what Gomez is saying. He's saying, woo her. Admire her, make her feel like she's the most sublime creature on the planet. You know, you don't need to do it Gomez style, but what does your partner like? How do they like to be built up? And what are the things, like when you're dating, it's easy to see all the positives.
Yeah.
And for some reason you get married and you get a few years in.
Everything that was great becomes, why are these birds so noisy?
And a marriage is like a garden, like you gotta water it and give it sunlight. And even though the Adamses don't much care for sunlight.
My darling, it's you I'm worried about. The stress, all this squabbling.
Oh, I'll be fine. I'm just like any modern woman, trying to have it all. A loving husband, a family. It's just I wish I had more time to seek out the dark forces and join their hellish crusade. That's all.
I love it.
You can, you shall, so it must be.
But how?
So the third principle in making marriage work is turning towards each other instead of away. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people, they get wrapped up in their own passion projects or they get wrapped up in the things that they want to do with their life, instead of taking time to say, hey, what you want matters to me. Mm-hmm. What's going on with you matters to me. You're, like the stresses that you're dealing with. And so I love in this scene that Gomez shows he's going to bring his day to a complete stop and he's going to attend to what's going on with her.
The most important thing in my life right now is what's up with you. Yeah.
And the Gomez talk about having 15-minute stress-reducing conversations every day where you just talk about, you can talk about the good things or you can talk about not related to the relationship. Because if you're saying, here's some things that stress me out and they're your fault, then it's not building closeness. That could be a separate conversation.
Sure.
But to have a conversation about, here's what's going on with me, and just to have the other person either listen or offer solutions is very, very bonding. And that's the thing, it only needs to be 15 minutes because life gets busy.
This magnificent piece is encrusted with rubies and 15 emerald chips.
I love that her hair's all messed up because she can't get it off.
It was donated by Morticia and Gomez ADDAMS.
So they donated
Remember,
it for the auction.
Remember, this year over half our proceeds will benefit the elderly and the mentally disabled. I'll open a bidding at $5,000.
Not good enough. $20,000!
What are they doing?
I have 20.
25.
25.
30.
35! It is divina.
50.
I have $50,000.
Your turn, my ecstasy.
50,000 going once, 50,000 going twice.
Hey, whatever gets you going, man.
To Morticia ADDAMS for $50,000.
Can we talk about that they just focus on him and we don't even see what's going on?
We don't see what's going on. And then her moan takes us into the next scene. Uh-huh. We kept that shot in there because it's like, what a weird, funny, just bizarre cut of like Ford Probe. Ah! What are they doing? Are clothes flying?
Right.
What is happening right now that they're making those noises?
Like, we have her moans, and we have the judge's face.
Like, it's so great. Oh, man. It's just...
Speaking of the ADDAMS' passionate relationship, there is an idea among some people that sex will fix everything in a relationship. I explore whether or not that's true in this Mend and Light video, so check that out.
Brilliant.
Okay, so this illustrates number 4, which is letting your partner influence you. And I love that he starts with the, you know, he's like, ha, not good enough, 20,000. And then he gets to 25. And then he turns to her and he says, cara mia. And what I love is it's a question.
Yeah.
He's like, do you want to go along with this?
Do you want to play?
Yeah. Do we want to? He's not telling her to bid. He's not. He's asking her.
That's a good point. It's a question. It's not like. Now you.
Yeah.
You know, it's a different thing. That's interesting.
And so because he's not demanding it of her, she's giving it freely. Mm-hmm. She's accepting influence, but the difference between accepting influence and your partner telling you what to do is that it's a request. It's a question. That comes with a recognition that you don't have to do things my way. It's a sign of respect.
Right.
How long has it been since we've waltzed?
Oh, Gomez. Hours.
I've said this before, that the sexiest thing is someone who treats you with respect. Mm-hmm. And we actually see this. He treats her with respect. And the moment he asks her if she wants to play this game, she feels respected and thus begins the foreplay.
And the foreplay lasts for 3 bids. And that's it.
You know,
and look, if auctions are your foreplay... More power to you.
I think the implication is that literally anything is
I think literally anything. Listen, if you have a relationship where you can turn anything into foreplay...
That's a beautiful thing.
That is magical. So there's a great scene in the film where Morticia is talking to her mother. Mm-hmm. And, you know, she says, his trains are everywhere. And then we cut upstairs to where he's playing with his trains, which when this movie came out when I was like 9 or 10 years old and had my model trains, this was my favorite scene of the movie. He's like, well, all the trains and stuff, and then he explodes them. But also, it's such an interesting, like, I think it gets back to the love map stuff that you were talking about.
Yeah.
Where she knows exactly what playing with his trains means.
Oh, no.
Father's playing with his trains.
Trains are everywhere means he's stewing and trying to figure out what's going on.
And he's stressed out and he's overwhelmed and yeah.
So he suspects that Fester is not who he says he is and all of this stuff. And all of these suspicions come to a head in this next scene that I think we want to talk about.
These trains are everywhere. The children are beside themselves. Is that for your brother? I don't think so.
Look at all these just dumb jokes.
This can't go on. How can I help him? Tell me, Mama.
Every single scene has just a dumb murder joke in it.
Adultery?
Oh, no.
Financial money troubles.
No.
Turned into toad or reptile.
Is there an index?
So this is just a real brief example of what John Gottman says, number five, is solve your solvable problems. That there's a certain percentage of problems in a marriage that are unsolvable. You're never going to solve them. It just comes down to personality differences, or it comes down to just, like, things can get better. You can grow for each other. You can change for each other. You can evolve for each other. But at the end of the day, you're always going to be you. So there are some problems that are unsolvable. So you focus, and this is like our radical acceptance episode, you focus on those things that you can control. You focus on those things that you can solve.
Turned into a rodent or a, what was it, rodent or lizard?
Yeah, right. And so here she's just consulting with her mom. And I love this. The little thing I love about it is that she is actively looking to solve a problem for her husband.
Sure, yeah.
That she's not saying this is his problem or he can just go ahead and deal with it. That she cares enough to be looking for outside help and looking for solutions. So speaking of solving your solvable problems, the Addams are going to go to what they think is a credible therapist.
Dr. Pinderschloss.
Yes.
With the goofiest accent.
So let's watch this scene and talk about what it means for their marriage.
A faker! A phony! An utter fraud! A base deceit!
Talking about Fester.
Addams! I believe I'm understanding. I can help Jess.
Who he suspects is a fraud.
The theory of displacement. Is this familiar?
No. Tish?
Oh, it is too exciting. I will explain.
Is it unpleasant?
Deeply. Your very own brother, you drive him away. Go, off with you. But then you are feeling the little black monster.
Pugsley.
Guilt. Your brother returns, you feel guilty, you displace.
I do?
The feelings in your brain cells, they bubble and collide. You suspect things. You love him, but you resent him. Love, hate, hate, love. Like for Mama, no?
But I didn't hate my mother. It was an accident.
It's a very common psychosis. I'm seeing it every day.
Lucky doctor.
Displacement. How bizarre. And here I thought Fester was the problem. He's sullen.
He's furtive.
Backstabbing.
He sulks.
I suspect him.
You're unbalanced.
And I hate him. By God, you're right! He is Fester!
Thank you, Dr. Pinterschloss.
I do what I can.
Okay, so this is number six of the seven principles of making marriage work, which is overcoming gridlock. What's going on?
I just can't with this movie. It's just so much. I love it.
I didn't hate my mother.
The
was an
black
accident.
Monster, Pugsley.
I didn't hate my mother. It was an accident. There's like so many throwaway lines that
so
suggest
much.
A very disturbing history.
Oh, man.
Do you remember our honeymoon?
That glorious cruise.
No calls.
No care.
No survivors.
So Dr. Pinderschloss is a fraud. That's part of the plot point.
Right.
But as pertains to Morticia and Gomez, they have no problem seeking the help of a counselor.
Sure, yeah.
They have no problem saying, we've got a gridlock situation. We've got something that we don't know how to solve it. We don't know how to get past it. What Dr. Gottman calls overcoming gridlock is getting help to move past things, to find solutions, to get unstuck. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you can't find solutions. Sometimes it's about enduring. But that couples that make their relationship work, they don't just stay stuck on a problem and they just stay there for years.
Right.
And I've seen that with couples in therapy where they're just like, we just kind of tried to work around it. You know, yeah. Like almost like a growth or a cancer or something where you just try and live your life around it until it becomes something that you can't avoid anymore.
Right.
And happy couples, balanced couples, couples that make things work, at a certain point, they're going to say, it's okay for us to get help and it's not shameful. And even though this therapist is a fraud, Morticia and Gomez have zero problem, like, going to a professional and getting some help.
And here I thought Fester was the problem.
And that's awesome.
We're here to talk about Lisa's popcorn, but Jono's not going to be talking because he's too busy eating Lisa's popcorn. We have partnered with them. They have launched a subscription box where you can get 6 flavors. One of them is missing because Jono is eating it.
Because I absconded with the cookies and cream. Sorry, I'm not talking.
It's
cookies and cream.
It's really good.
So I want you to have this.
I want me to have this.
Oh, shut up. It's not just a cookies and cream flavor. They actually have cookie bits.
No, they have cookie bits in it. There's actual Oreo. Look at this. So it's like the white chocolate popcorn, but there's also little bits of Oreo in it, and then...
It may be off-brand cookies and cream.
What it tastes like...
Oreo stuff.
...is heaven.
Dang, holy crap.
You're gonna eat that whole handful, aren't you? This entire ad just went down the... Anyway, so we've partnered with them. Go to leesespopcorn.com/cinematherapy. It's the name of our channel. I'm sure you've heard of it. And use code CTherapy to get free shipping for life. Every box ships to you for free.
This is my O face. As in, oh man, this popcorn's good. What were you thinking?
You get 6 different flavors. You can choose the ones. Jono's probably just gonna get 6 of cookies and cream every month, guessing. Did you just steal my Oreo? These are mine. 6 flavors shipped to your door. Use code CTherapy. And the shipping is free. And it's Lisa's popcorn, and it's good.
That's tasty.
I'm turned on right now. Why?
So, let's talk about the last number 7 for 7 principles of making marriage work. Let's take a look.
How all occasions do inform against me.
So this is a school play. Fester's helped them with their special effects.
If I must strike you dead, I will. A hit! A very powerful hit!
They're so excited.
Oh, proud death! What faces torn thine eternal cell? Sweet oblivion! Open your arms!
Okay.
Bravo!
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 Bravo! Oh my gosh, it's so messed up.
Okay. Okay, so two points here.
Oof.
Filmmaking, number one, the editing is so brilliant, like the cuts to the people, you know, getting sprayed, like, and then just the shocked looks on every, like, they're all timed so well to, like, just, they take one scene that's hilarious and they manage to get, like, 6 big laughs out of it.
Yeah, yeah.
Because of just the way they're cutting back and forth. Number two, and this is just a therapy thing for me, probably, I had a huge crush on Christina Ricci after this movie.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
All through being a teen.
Oh, yeah. And then Addams Family Values, and she's in summer camp, and she's got, like, a little romance going.
Oh, yeah.
And we were, like, the exact same age. Yeah,
yeah, the exact same age. And I just had a thing for Christina Ricci. And watching this scene, I'm like, what's wrong with me?
There is nothing wrong with you.
I had a huge crush on that.
You were into goth. That was the term in the 90s. You were into the goth girls, apparently.
I had... Listen, I am what I am.
So this is an example of creating shared meaning, right? Mm-hmm. That marriage isn't just paying bills and running a household and keeping things clean and raising kids. And, like, what are your partner's dreams? What do they want out of life? And actively knowing that and seeking to make that happen. And then finding common ground, you won't have all of the exact same dreams, but creating shared meaning, a lot of times it's, we have shared dreams, but then it's also, I just love you and want to make your dreams come true. And that's the shared meaning, is like we go both ways with that. Now, in their case, they have a deep shared meaning of their family.
Yeah.
I mean, their family is literally everything. Her mom, his brother, their kids, the time they spend together, the things they do together. I mean, as disturbing as the scene is, I love how proud of their kids
they're
they are.
They're so proud. And to be fair, if my kids did this exact same thing, I would be just as proud as Gomez Adams.
You would
My wife would respond differently.
But you'd be like, look at the gore!
Look at how much, oh, I'm so, they did this!
They did this! And I could totally see you talking with someone from the audience who was like, that was horrifying. And you're like, I know.
I know, right? Well, and my middle son, Sam, actually spent an entire breakfast one time because, you know, we watched the film together as a family.
Yeah.
Because I'm a good parent.
Yeah, and I watched this with my kids too.
Yeah, oh, they loved it. They absolutely loved it. And he spent an entire breakfast trying to figure out how they did it because he wants to do it.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's so funny because adults were like, oh, the kids can't handle this. This is bad for kids. And what's funny is I watched this with my kids and this was their favorite part.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Look what they did. Oh, it's so funny. They're spraying blood on everyone.
Oh, man. But, like, this family has game night. I mean, in their case, it's not Yahtzee, it's Raise the Dead.
Sure.
You know, the family, but they're, what do the kids want? You know, oh, you want to torture your brother. Well, all right, let me support you in that.
I said no.
Please?
Oh, all right.
And so even though it's very dark humor, and even though in real life, you know, a lot of this would be absolutely terrible, the actual undercurrent of how much this family loves each other, how much they support each other, yeah. And how Morticia and Gomez, I mean, we looked at the auction scene, how they kind of like, they tune out the rest of the world. I mean, whatever's happening, there's a lot of intense pleasure going on, and they've just kind of tuned out, like, everybody else there.
And I do have one question about that.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, this is a great example in a lot of ways of a healthy relationship. The deep level of obsession and just like...
That they have for each other?
Interwoven. Like, is it too much? I mean, because that can get unhealthy, right?
Yeah, I mean, they play it for comedy here. One thing I would say is that Morticia and Gomez never neglect their kids.
Okay.
I don't see them neglecting their kids. I do see that they could get arrested for public indecency. Like, I see that could be an actual thing that happens. But,
The cops in the world of Adam's family seem to not... I don't know if they've just bought the cops off. Like, they do a lot of stuff that you can't do.
To Morticia Adams for $50,000.
But at the end of the day... Their marriage is everything to each other. Supporting each other's dreams, turning towards one another, creating shared meaning, not being afraid to get help, not being afraid to look for solutions instead of just pretending that the problems don't exist. I mean, all across the board, it is a very healthy, beautiful marriage and a wonderful example of 7 principles for making marriage work.
Well, there you go. I think we've all learned something from these horrible, goth, weirdo, monster people.
We love them. And we so do you, as you should.
So much. If you would like to learn even more about how to have a healthy relationship than you learned in this episode, this guy over here has made some strength builders that you can get on our membership site, thecinematherapy.com. Mm-hmm. So
learn how to actually apply the skills. So until next time.
He's sullen.
He sulks.
He's furtive.
He's backstabbing.
I suspect him.
I hate him. And watch movies!